I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting our favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today is Friday, and I am starting this vlog off today with a mini skincare haul. I only got two things, but I wanted to show it to you guys because I'm pretty excited about it. I placed an order with Heyday, which you guys probably haven't heard of because it's not as well known, I think, as a retailer. You can buy skincare products, but also they are better known for their facials. So they have boutiques around the US, I believe. I think it's a US company. They also sell skincare products on their website. So I had some credit left over. I wanted to use that money up, and I grabbed two items that I was really excited to try out. It sounds amazing for the winter months, and the thing that I'm talking about, I will just go straight into it, is the One Love Organics Skin Saver, and it's a multitasking wonder balm. And basically, you can use this for any type of skin needs. You can use it on your face, your body, elbows. It's just basically like a glorified Aquaphor, or like an Aquaphor. Someone actually on the website described this as Aquaphor on crack. So I'm very excited for that because I need all the help that I can get in terms of cracked and chapped lips. Like, my lips today were so dry, and I know that it's just going to keep on getting worse and worse throughout this winter, and I thought I would pick this one up. And also because my skin on my face is a lot more drier, especially around the eyes, because I am using a retinol? I'm using tretinoin, which is a type of, I think, vitamin A, and my skin is still not adjusting to it because my skin is pretty, I don't know, it's just being a little reactive to retinol. So I thought I would give this a go. I'm gonna try putting this kind of like around my eyes where I get really flaky. This has chia seed, oat oil. You guys know I love oats in everything. It is a really, really aesthetic jar. I love these types of jars. It reminds me of the packaging for, what is that called? Aesop. It has that same kind of amber packaging with white font and a white. Wow, I almost broke this. Slippery hands today. Well, it's sturdy, it didn't break. I will link everything in the description as always. It has a really nice kind of herbally scent. It is thick, like this baby is thick. Like literally, it doesn't come out. It's very it looks very waxy, but we'll see. And my camera is about to die. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I just had to switch the battery out. Also, I'm drinking coffee at like 5 o'clock in the afternoon, evening. I don't think that's a good thing. I might not be able to sleep tonight. The next thing that I got is by the brand Naturopathica. It is their Manuka Honey Cleansing Balm, and I wanted to get this because I feel like I can never have enough cleansing balms because I always go through them so quickly. I use them almost every night because I wear makeup almost every day. As a makeup artist, I just like makeup, so I put on makeup every day. I know a lot of people don't because it's COVID and no one really sees your face, but I still get on meetings, like conference calls and stuff like that, and sometimes I have the camera on and I just like to be prepared, you know? It's nice getting ready in the morning. I like having a routine. So anyway, I'm going off on a tangent, but I do use a cleansing balm quite often, almost every single day, and I thought it wouldn't hurt to try out a new one. This got really, really good reviews on the website. It was pretty expensive, not gonna lie. I think both of these were pretty expensive, but it has really, really good reviews. So I'm excited to try it out. This smells like honey. It smells really great. I'm gonna definitely need like a spoon to like get the product out because this hole is not that big. Like, I guess you can like dig your fingers in it, but I would rather use like a little spatula or a spoon to get product out of this. This is super thick. Like, this as well is not going anywhere. That is all I got from Heyday. I will link these below if you guys are interested, and I will definitely keep you guys updated if those are worth the money. Oh, also, I wanna show you guys that I got my nails done. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy with how they turned out. They look so cute. I got inspiration from Pinterest. I showed them a picture. The nail design is definitely fall inspired and I love it so, so much. It uses a lot of browns and like neutrals, like I love. Aren't these so, so cute? Oh my gosh, she did such a great job. I'll show you this way too. I love it. These are my real nails, by the way. I just get gel, but I keep my nails super long because I really like the look of long nails, but I also don't like getting acrylics or dip or anything like that because I don't like damaging my actual like real nails, so I always get gel. And I just keep my nails super long so when I have gel on, it looks pretty fake, you know? They are so cute, I'm obsessed. I am going to do a more like Christmassy inspired nail art next month. So I'll go ahead and show you guys what my nails look like for next month as well when I get to that. It's already getting dark. I freaking hate this time of the year because it gets dark literally, like I said in my other video, at like 4 o'clock. It's 4:43 p.m. and the sun is already setting. And it makes me really kind of, I don't know, it makes me feel so like down. The gloomy weather, it's not gloomy though, like it was such a beautiful day today. The sun was shining and it was in the 50s, which is comfortable for me with a lightweight jacket. So I have nothing to complain about in terms of the weather, but the fact that it just gets so dark so fast, it just makes me feel so like sluggish so quickly, you know? I need to start waking up just earlier then and then sleeping earlier. I think that'll pretty much fix the problem, but I am such a night owl. I cannot fall asleep before midnight, basically. Anyway, I also had my physical therapy session earlier today and that went really well. My back is recovering slowly but surely, so I'm still in a little bit of discomfort but nothing too major. Oh, I didn't tell you guys. So today's Friday, but I actually took the day off because I wanted a long weekend to kind of catch up on life, basically. So I got a bunch of different sweaters and outerwear for romper. I've been getting a lot of questions from you guys on my Instagram where I got these. So I'm going to link all of these in the description if you guys are interested in checking them out for your own dog, because I think these are so adorable for the winter months. He likes to wear these sweaters in the winter because it does keep him warm. As cute as it is, they do actually serve a function, and especially when it's snowing outside, these sweaters and outerwear actually keep his fur from getting knotted and attached to ice and stuff like that. He gets so many compliments and so much attention from everyone. I'm gonna show you guys each of the ones that I got because I think they're so cute. I'm not gonna put them on him as like a try on, but I will show you guys like the print and everything, and I will link everything below if you guys wanna check it out. Sorry, the lighting is a little crappy here, but I'm working with what I have. Let me show you guys each and every one of them because they are so freaking cute. I did go overboard, I understand, but we had to get rid of a lot of his apparel. I know, still excessive, but we had to get rid of a lot of them and donate them because they were too small on him now because he finally stopped growing. He is about 22 pounds as a Cavalier. He's about 2.5 years old, so he's done growing. So I won't have to like replace these as I did with the other batch of clothing that I got him like a long time ago when he was still a growing puppy. I got a bunch of Christmassy ones because I thought these were so adorable. This one is one of my favorites. This one is a blue base sweater with red and white like flowers and mooses on them. This is the second one. This is the pink one that I was talking to you about. It kind of reminds me of an elf. It's like the pink and green and maroon colors in here. I think this is also so adorable. The next one is also just a plain sweater. These ones are really cute because it has these sleeves, so it covers his legs a little bit more. A gray sweater with these little pom-pom little knots on them. Love, love this one. Had to get some neutrals, okay, because I'm his mother. I got him a parka It is a fleece lined parka. This was actually pretty cheap. I think it was only $20. Oh, by the way, I totally forgot to mention that I got all of these on Chewy, but the website is just not very good at filtering. Their search engine is just not the best. So I had to really dig deep into that website to find the cute ones. Sometimes you gotta like click into the ugly ones to find the cute ones. But I did the work for you. It is all in the description if you guys are interested in any of these ones. I love this parka. It is so cute. It is an olive color parka with a hoodie. It also has a snap button for the hood so that it doesn't constantly like come down their head, because a lot of the time dogs don't like when the hood hits them in the face because it like makes them feel like very claustrophobic. So you can clip it. I got a variety of different colors because I just wanted one of everything. Hoodie that I got is, I love this one, it's so cute. It is a fuzzy white hoodie with gold like flecks, like little gold specks all over it. I mean, you guys know how much I love gold and anything fuzzy. So he looks so, so cute with this on. It also has a hoodie. The next two things are the same print, but in different colors. I got a red and a gray. The red one is obviously way more Christmassy. It is the same kind of moose slash deer situation. It has a hood. It is a fleece material on the inside and the outside. The other color is in the color gray. This he can wear kind of all throughout winter, and it's not like too in your face Christmas. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that little dog apparel haul. I will, like I said, link everything that I found on Chewy below. Also, I forgot to tell you, if you guys are wondering what size he wears a large. All of those are by one brand. It's called Frisco. He's a 22 pound Cavalier. I mean, you guys have seen him on my vlogs everywhere. So hopefully you can gauge his size so that you can reference to it if you are trying to buy for your own pup. If you're following me on Instagram, you would have seen some clips of him wearing some of the sweaters. So make sure to follow me there because you will see all the cuteness of Romper on there real time and more of my day-to-day life. So go ahead and follow me on Instagram. Oh, look at you, sweetie. Look at you, little cutie pie. All right. Hello, you guys. Today is Saturday. Sorry, I'm trying to like balance this camera with my with my left hand while I have a dog sitting on my lap. I just finished baking raspberry lemon cookies, which I will show you guys in just a second. We're bringing them to two friendsgivings today. So two of my really close friends are hosting friendsgiving on the same day. So we're going to the first one in about an hour and a half, and then we're gonna go to the second one afterwards. So I decided to bake some cookies because I feel like I kind of missed baking because I really don't get to do that very often, and friendsgivings are a good excuse to bake. I'm going to try to make mulled wine to bring as well because I really like making mulled wine for the holidays, and it's like the perfect opportunity. Today has been super busy already. It is right now 3 p.m. I already got ready for the day because I wanted to get that out of the way and then try to bake and get everything situated. I absolutely love how my makeup turned out today. I really like this kind of winged soft eyeliner look that I did. I used the Natasha Denona Biba palette that I picked up during the VIP sale at Sephora. Let me show you guys the cookies that I baked. They look really, really pretty because since they use raspberries, the color is just like so vibrant, and I'm obsessed with what they look like. They taste really good too. I just can't get up with him like this. Hello. All right, so we are in the kitchen now. Here are the cookies. Look at that vibrant color. Oh my gosh. I will do a taste test in a little bit after these cool down. Also, I wanted to show you guys my outfit of the day to Friendsgiving. It's very simple, but I thought I would show it to you guys anyway. We'll start from the necklace. This is from Ana Luisa. I'm not sure if you can even see that because my camera is trying to focus on something else. Sorry. The top is from Free People. It's just a really simple tank top, and I'm gonna wear a brown cardigan over it. These are kind of like corduroy material paper bag pants that I got from Zara a little bit ago. And I don't know what I'm gonna do about shoes, but I'm wearing these slippers from Amazon. I've been wearing these a ton lately. Let me show you my cardigan because I think those are really cute. Oh, by the way, I bought flowers to gift to my friend because she recently got a new job. And I wanted to put it in this vase for her and arrange it, but it looks so sparse. I am getting Charlie to buy another bouquet and bring it so we can fill this vase up a little bit more because it just looks a little sad. Anyway, I'm gonna gift her this too. She has a dog, and I thought this was so, so cute. It's a bandana that I made. I used to have a bandana business on Etsy, so I have a lot of these bandanas that I have made before, but this one is very fall, has pumpkins and acorns and everything, and it's a snap-on. Super, super cute. It would fit her dog perfectly, so I'm gonna give that to her as well. I'm gonna wear this cardigan. It is from Just, I don't know, it was like a cardigan that I bought from a boutique, but let me go ahead and put it on and show you guys what it looks like. So this is the cardigan, and it's so fuzzy and super cozy. I love this color. You guys already know how much I love brown tones for the fall. I've been obsessed, and I think this just goes so perfectly with this tank top. It just looks really cohesive. This is my outfit. It's been 10 minutes, so it's been sitting out, just taking its shape and everything. So let me go ahead and try it. It's a little taste test, but these are what the cookies look like, and they're still pretty soft. So I think I didn't over bake them as I thought I did. Yeah, it's still fluffy. Mm. Yeah, very good. It's kind of like a hybrid between like a bread and a cookie. Oh wow, that's really good. All right, you guys, I got another bouquet of flowers and then arranged it so it looks so much fuller now. It actually looks really good. This is from far away. And in every angle, it's still full. I actually really like arranging flowers. It's kind of fun. I'm excited to give this to my friend. Hopefully she likes it. And Charlie right now, oh my gosh, our kitchen is a mess. Let's see what Charlie's up to. He is making mulled wine. How's the mulled wine going?
It's going.
So we're gonna boil it. What's in it right now? We have Merlot, like a bucket of Merlot basically.
We have Merlot.
Blood oranges.
Yeah, a bunch of oranges.
Cardamom. Cinnamon?
Yes, we do have cinnamon. We have some star anise. We have some cloves. Mm. We have some allspice. Where should we put you? I don't know.
We need to put honey in it.
Yeah, I put like
and brandy, right?
A third cup of honey. Okay. I haven't put the brandy yet.
Okay, but we are going to put brandy in.
Yes, we will be putting.
Okay, perfect.
All of this. Just kidding.
And I have these cookies prepared. I have them in different containers because I'm gonna bring one for my first friend and then my second friend. That's what we're up to right now. Probably gonna clean up the kitchen just a little bit before we leave. Today is Black Friday, and I feel like I have been shopping so much, like an excessive amount. So I am stopping myself right here because I've been on my computer all this morning, basically buying so much makeup. Let me know in the comments if you guys are actually interested in seeing like a Black Friday haul, because I bought so much makeup. It's not even funny? Definitely not funny for my wallet. I hope you guys had an amazing Thanksgiving. Charlie and I had dinner with our sister-in-law's parents' place and it was really, really great. We just got like food from Whole Foods. I had no idea that Whole Foods has like this catering thing for Thanksgiving where you can literally just like pay per person for like a Thanksgiving feast and they just cater. So that's what we did yesterday. I don't think anyone wanted to cook because Charlie and I cooked for friendsgiving that we had last week for, at our place. We hosted friendsgiving, so we were all like cooked out. Like we do not want to do anything Thanksgiving related in terms of cooking at all anymore. So we were like, okay, thank God no one has to like cook for the family Thanksgiving dinner. I thought that I would sit down today and just talk to you guys. Why am I doing this so much? I'm so distracted right now. It is a beautiful, beautiful day outside and it is 2:52. It's Friday. Like I said, it's Black Friday and I've been doing a ton of shopping, but I thought that I would film my Q&A portion for today's video because I have been putting it off for a very, very long time. I posted on Instagram. That's where I usually get a lot of my ideas, like video ideas and Q&A, like questions for Q&A videos. So make sure to follow me on Instagram if you aren't already, because I do interact with you guys a lot more on Instagram. It's just easier for me. I have my phone on me at all times. So make sure to follow me over there. I will go ahead and link my social media. It's always linked in the description. But I wanted to film that part today because it's been so long since I've asked those questions. I have a beer with, actually this is not beer. This is an orange cider. I think it's called like Austin's Ciders or something. I really like their brand of ciders. It's not as tart as some ciders can be. I'm not a huge fan of like tart beers or tart ciders. It's just not my thing. I like mine a little bit sweeter and less tart and sour. It's just, I don't like it. But this one is great. It's a great balance. And this is the orange flavor. And I'm not sure if you guys can see the writing on this cup. It says bride on it with like a line and a heart. And it has my name on it because this was one of the things that I ordered on Etsy before our wedding because I wanted some kind of like, wedding themed Charlie and I, his and hers, like souvenirs type of thing. And I love this so much. Charlie and I really like beer. We're huge like IPA drinkers, which is not very common amongst women. I think I'm the rare bird that likes IPAs, but I love it. I love IPA beers and we just had to get like a beer glass that has our names on it. And his obviously says groom and mine says bride. So cheers. Before I just ramble on more and more, I'm in a very talkative mood today, which is a great thing for Q&As. I think it's always more fun to film these types of videos when you're in a talkative mood. You're just more energetic and enthusiastic, you know? So I ask you guys questions on my Instagram about my first house purchase, about like Charlie and I's relationship or anything like kind of personal. I asked you guys if you had any questions and I did get some submissions. So I'm just gonna go through in no particular order and there might be some redundant questions. So I'll just go ahead and skip those. So the first question is from my friend Shai. I met her on YouTube as well. So hello Shai, if you're watching. She said, I think you mentioned you guys got a townhouse. Why a townhouse? Was this your original choice? Is this going to be your forever home and or would you possibly move in the future? Yes. We did get a townhouse and it actually was surprisingly our original choice because we didn't want to, this is our first home purchase. We've never purchased a property before and this was really, really exciting for us, but we already knew that we are still very young. I mean, Charlie's 28, I'm 27. We knew that we wanted to still keep it pretty low maintenance. I know that's such a silly reason, but we just didn't want like a huge backyard and a huge front yard where we would have to like upkeep with the plants and like grass and have a lot of land that we would have to like take care of. Yes, it was our original choice. I think it would be amazing to be able to have our own single house in the long term, like, it, you know, in the future. But I think for now, a townhome fits more of our style. We definitely didn't want to buy a condo because we come from living in apartments and it's just like too crammed. I really like my space. I love being able to like do home decor, as you guys already know if you have been following my channel for a while. I love interior design and home decor, but we wanted to keep it still downscale, like lower scale. We're not gonna be, you know, upkeeping the house. We wanted to, you know, keep a, get a townhome where we didn't have to do so much work on the house. Although we did a ton of renovations since moving in, so we did do a lot of work in the house, but that's like inside the house. I think like outdoor upkeep and maintaining a house is way different than having, you know, a tidy space inside, so it's totally different. Answering the second part of her question, we are definitely not going to be staying in this house forever. We might rent it out in the future, like keep the property and rent it out, or we might resell and buy a bigger home, or I don't know, we don't know yet, but this is definitely not going to be our forever home. It's a beautiful house, and we are so lucky that we, I mean, this is our first home and it's just such a stunning home, but we definitely would like a little more space, like, you know, a single family home in the future. I think right now it's perfect for us, like with just Charlie, me, and Romper, our dog. It's like the perfect size and everything, but I think in down the future, you know, it would be better for us to like upgrade to a single family home. And she said, would you possibly move in the future? Yes. I'm not like married to this location. We are always open to the possibility of moving to a different area, like a different state, and living there for a little bit and then coming back, or I don't know, like buying a property somewhere else, like completely different than the Washington DC metro area. We have been in the DC area. We don't technically live in DC, we live in Virginia, but it's super close to DC. It's about a 30-minute drive, so it's very accessible. So it's fun. We get to live in the suburbs, but still have access to a major city, which is amazing. I love this area. I mean, I grew up in this area besides the fact that I like was born in South Korea, but all my life ever since moving to the US, I grew up here, like in this area location. So it would be really fun to be able to have an experience somewhere else. I definitely want that for us. It's just right now, we just bought a house here. So for the next, you know, for the near future, we are staying here for a while, for a couple years at least. So yeah, that's TBD. My other friend, Jamie, who is also on YouTube, she says, what are you most excited with the new house? Oh my gosh, honestly, I'm excited about everything. I mean, we've been living in this house since, I want to say June or July. So it's been a couple months. It's been about, 4 months since we've been here. And I was the most excited about just curating a space for Charlie and I and Romper. One thing that I really love about owning a home is that you get to make it yours. You get to do whatever you want with the walls. You get to, like, you know, bash down walls if you want to. We didn't do that. You get to replace floors. You get to paint however you want the house to be. I mean, you know, not the exterior, because exterior, we have an HOA, which is a homeowners association, and there are like set of rules that you gotta follow in terms of the outside of the home for curb appeal and all that stuff. But for the inside, you get to do everything and you don't have to worry about all these like little holes that you're making, because you're not gonna have your security deposit back from your apartment or whoever you're renting from. So there are things that you just don't have to worry about, but also a lot of things that you do have to worry about being a homeowner. It's like a whole different ballpark. But in that sense, I love having that ownership. You know, I get to do whatever I want with it, and we don't have to worry about moving next year, or we don't have to really worry about our rent going up every year. It's ridiculous how much we were paying for an apartment, and we basically like quadrupled our size, like living space in square footage, but we're paying like just a little bit more than our rent that we were paying back then for an apartment that only had like two bedrooms and one bath. You would be surprised how much money rent just like, it just goes down the drain. There's like no investment at all. It's just literally just going down the drain. Owning a house in a way is just like, I'm excited for those things. It's just like more of a not permanent but like semi-permanent solution and situation. You don't have to feel like you're always like having to search for the next place that you're gonna live, like those things. Sorry, that was, yeah, I'm in a very talkative mood today. This question was asked by Wenyu, my other friend on YouTube. What was a deal breaker for you when choosing a house, and what were your top three criteria? My deal breaker, I actually didn't really have a deal breaker. I just had non-negotiables. We had to check off those boxes if we were going to consider move or consider buying this home. If we didn't have those three things or however many, that was a deal breaker. So I guess it kind of ties together. The things that we were looking for in our home was a two-car garage, because we have two cars and it is such a bitch to find parking around this area. We didn't want just one because Charlie and I both own our own car. It would have been such a hassle for one of us to like be in the driveway and then another person be in the garage, and that person in the garage can't come out. We didn't want to have to fuss with that, so we were like, okay, two-car garage. The second thing that was a non-negotiable, which might be pretty unrealistic for some areas, we got really, really lucky because this is a hard non-negotiable to have. It's pretty challenging to find a home that's like, that's what you want, but is also an end unit townhome. So that was my priority. I was like, if we're going to get a townhome, it has to be an end unit. The reason for that is because I didn't want to deal with obnoxious, loud neighbors on both sides. I think, you know, the chances of having like one bad neighbor is like one thing, but having two bad neighbors would be another. So I was like, okay, let's like lessen the chance of having bad, like loud neighbors. And it's just more privacy and more land. Usually end units have a lot more windows, so you get a lot more natural light, which is also very, very important to me. I love my natural light. And with an end unit, that is usually the case. You get more natural lighting because you have more walls to put windows. You do get a little bit more square footage typically as well if you're an end unit. So we got really lucky, and those two things we found in this home, like the two-car garage and the end unit. And I think one other thing that was kind of like a non-negotiable-ish, like teetering towards like really nice to have, was an open floor plan, because I am obsessed with homes that just look really spacious, that doesn't have too many walls like collapsing on each other, or like, you know, I'm not a huge fan of those floor plans. To each their own. I think some sectioned off like areas of homes are beautiful if done right, but personally, I just really like the aesthetic of like an open floor plan. That's what we got. I mean, our living space, like the second floor, which is our main floor, is just like a one big floor, and the walls do have these segments, but it's not all the way in. It's not like closed in on each other. So it has like pretty big openings where it looks like it's divided still. So it makes sense, it's intuitive where you would put your furniture and all that stuff, but it still looks really, really large. Oh, sorry, there was a fourth one. I wanted the inside of the home to be kind of upgraded. I wasn't looking for something that was like completely remodeled, like super modern. You know, it's really hard to find a home like that. And especially in the market that we were in, oh my gosh, the competition for buying homes was nuts. It was crazy. It's an unrealistic expectation to find a home that's reasonably priced in that kind of competitive market. be under budget but still upgraded and all nice. It's just like impossible to find a home like that. I mean, you would have to spend at least $1 million on a house like that, even for a townhome. But I wanted it to be like not like dingy, you know, like not like run down on the inside. Like, I was fine doing some work on our own because I think that's kind of fun. Like, you get to pick like all the finishes yourself, renovate how you want your house to look like, and you have a lot more control over that. But I also didn't want it to be like a fixer-upper, if that makes sense. I wanted it to still feel like I can like see myself living in that space without doing any renovations. It was important for me to feel like this is still my kind of aesthetic. Our home was fine before, but now it's amazing after renovating. So I couldn't be happier with our purchase. Okay, so that was only 3 questions I got through. There's a lot more. The next question is, what is your favorite part of the house? This is a really fun question. I like so many parts of this house. I really like the main floor, like the living room and dining room and kitchen area. All of those 3 areas are on the same floor for us, and I love it. I have been having so much fun decorating for like fall, and now we're gonna switch over to Christmas decorations today. I'm gonna start doing that. It's not the master bedroom for sure, because our master bedroom right now, it needs a lot of work still. We are still waiting to get some furniture in that room. Right now, it's just very kind of chaotic. We have furniture like that really doesn't match. It's like a slow going process. We prioritize furnishing and decorating the main floor because that's what everyone else sees when we have guests and like family over. That's what they see. They're not gonna see the master bedroom, so it's fine. That can wait. That's why the master bedroom is not my favorite at the moment. I think at the moment right now is this room, like this area. It's the dining area. We have a beautiful West Elm table now. We have all of our chairs in, and we have some cute decor around. I love like the shelves that's like up there. I'm pretty sure you've already seen it, but I have these like wooden shelves that have like decor on it and really pretty wine glasses. So I just like love the vibe, and it just has a lot of potential for creativity in terms of home decor. Like, I decorate this area the most out of any room in the house, so I think the dining area. Where do you get your home decor inspo? Pinterest, girlfriend. Oh my gosh. If I am in doubt of how I'm gonna decorate a certain place or a certain area, Pinterest. That's the way to go. I literally just type in or search like, what, you know, dining room area inspo, like decor inspo or whatever, and Pinterest just has everything. Yeah, there's a lot of people who ask, where do I get my decor inspo? It's all Pinterest. I love Pinterest, what can I say? Another place that I really like getting inspo from is like furniture stores. Like, I love walking into like West Elm or like Our House or CB2 and just looking at how they decorated it, and like looking at catalogs and books and just kind of like not replicating it exactly or like buying the same things, because that'd be really expensive. I just get ideas or like take pictures and see how I can like recreate it. So those are like my other areas where I get decor inspo. How was the process of applying for a house? Any tips? Ooh, girl, this question is a heavy question because I am not a real estate agent, so this is not where I'm knowledgeable in at all. Even going through the process once, I still don't know anything. I feel like I lost all knowledge, like I threw it out the window once we were done. There's so many things that go in and out of buying a home. It's insane. Honestly, it just goes by so quick. Like, our purchase went through in like 2 days. We put in an offer after seeing the house that day, the same day. We saw the house in the morning or early afternoon. We put in the offer that evening, and then we got an answer the day after. And then we had to do like a counter offer thing. So in total, it took about 2 days for us to be under contract, basically. It's a lot of terminology that I think it's heavy loaded, but if you get a really, really good real estate agent to work with you, the process is a lot easier and they would be able to answer all of those questions. I just don't feel like I don't have the right credentials to answer those specifics. I apologize. I would be lying to myself if I think that I can do an adequate job of explaining, because I can't. My real estate agent, actually, his name is Christian, and he asked, who was y'all's agent? Did he do a good job? And yes, he did. He was so patient with us. We looked through several homes and he never made us feel like we had to say yes to a certain house. He was so involved in the process and just really patient with us as first home buyers that it made everything so much, like, that much smoother. So I think that's super, super important. How do you know that this house is the one? My friend Alice is asking this question, and honestly, that's hard to answer, because I never went into a house and I was like, oh my gosh, this is the one. I tried so hard not to get attached to certain homes because the market was so hot. People were buying homes like they were hotcakes, like they were going left and right. It was definitely the seller's market. I tried really hard to not get attached to homes. It happens, but I didn't let myself. So I never went into a home like, oh my gosh, this is the one. This is the perfect ideal home, because I don't think the perfect ideal home really exists, in my opinion. It's kind of like how I feel about soulmates. I don't think you have, I don't know. I think your soulmate is the person that you choose as your soulmate. That's a different conversation. But I think for homes, I just thought, like, you know, can I picture myself living here? Even for, like, semi-permanently, not like forever, because we came into the market thinking that this is going to be our first home and not our final home. So I think there was a little bit pressure off in that sense. I think we knew it was the one when, you know, we could see ourselves, like, we were like, oh, like, this would be so nice if we did this to it. And it checked all the boxes, like the necessary boxes, and that's why we decided to put in an offer. We only put in one offer and we got really, really lucky and we got the home, which is very rare. Our home actually also appraised higher, which, if you don't know anything about that, it's fine. It's not that important. Basically, it means that your house value, like, it gets, like, calculated by, like, certain criterias. What we paid was lower than what the value was valued at, which was really great, because you want that. You don't want it to appraise lower, because that means that you're overpaying and then you have to, like, compensate for the difference. It's a lot. When you are ready to buy a home, your real estate will explain all of that to you, but we got super, super blessed, and our house appraised a little bit higher, which was great. Do you and Charlie plan on buying more homes in the future? Yes. So yeah, I don't have to elaborate any further than that. Like I said, this is not our final home. We are definitely going to want to upgrade in the future, like way, way in the future, because yeah, we're not in the position to buy another home now, obviously. All right, those were a lot of questions. I do have several more. The second part might have to wait for the next vlog, because this is gonna get really long. I've already been filming this part of the video for 30 minutes. I'm going to save the next set of questions for the next vlog. So go ahead and stick around if you guys are interested in hearing more Q&A content. There's a lot more relationship related questions about me and Charlie and about our marriage and wedding and my ring and stuff like that. So make sure to subscribe to wait for the next set of Q&As. Hello, you guys. This is editing Amy here, and I totally forgot to film an outro to this vlog. So here I am saying goodbye for now. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed this really long vlog. I'm literally editing it right now and it's at 43 minutes. So I hope you guys like the long vlogs. I know some of you guys do, but other people probably prefer shorter vlogs. So I don't know. The shorter vlogs will be coming up in the next few weeks. So yeah, this one was a lot. It was jam-packed with content because this was like 2 weeks worth of things that I'm trying to pack into just one video. So I apologize for that if you don't enjoy it, but I hope you did. Please like if you haven't already, subscribe if you want to stick around, and I will talk to you guys in the comments. Bye.